Welcome to the journey home. My name is Catherine and I live in Nova Scotia, Canada. The following is an oracle reading of cards that I have chosen for you that I will read fully from and without advertisement. So please subscribe, hit that like, and share. Enjoy your reading. This card chosen for you is from the Fairies Oracle by Brian Froude. Card number 51. The Topsy Turvies, change of viewpoint, fresh looks, new ways of seeing. When life is confusing, the Turvies may come to visit you. Nothing draws them like a bit of mental muddle. They don't cause our disarray. We are very good at doing that for ourselves and each other, but they are attracted to it. Confusion is an important stage of growth, and they delight in helping things to grow. They live everywhere. Not only humans need their help and are exceedingly busy. Fortunately, they are quite prolific, so there are a lot of them. When the topsy-turvies show up, it indicates that someone needs to look again, to make an effort to see things from a different point of view. It suggests that confusion may exist because we are asking the wrong questions, or perhaps we have made assumptions that are incorrect, and we have to run into a brick wall built of those misconceptions. The Turvies ask us to back up, to question our assumptions, and to try to see things from viewpoints of the other people involved in our muddle. They ask us to let go of our attachment to our own point of view, to stop saying ought and should, especially about other people. Most emphatically, they suggest that we start trying to see things as they really are instead as someone thinks they should be. This card is a warning that someone involved in the question or issue at hand is mentally upside down, or possibly sideways. So as your message in a reading, this Turvies suggests that things need to be looked at from another angle. We need to back off from our emotional entanglement and look anew. Much of the apparent confusion about the issue is caused by a faulty point of view. Get the opinions of honest others and then relook at your own. Defensiveness and denial may be causing much difficulty. Try imagining that you are looking into the situation from the point of view of each of the others involved. This is not an exercise in deciding how the other ought to see things, but in discovering how they really do. Words like "he ought to see that" are not useful at this time. If the Turvies card turns up and another point of view does not readily suggest itself, it may be useful to draw another card for further information, or you might choose to do another reading, addressing that issue independently. Remember to pause to listen for hints from the Turvies themselves. They are the experts in the field. I believe no fairy is completely good or bad, but fluidly embodies both extremes. Before I read the second card for you, just a reminder to please hit the like and help me beat those algorithms. For every like that you give me is potentially 1,000 suggestions and recommendations on YouTube. Thank you and God bless. Enjoy the rest of the reading. This card chosen for you is from the Fairy Forest, an oracle of the wild green world by Lucy Cavendish. Card number 32, Faerie Godmother, revelation, discovery, epiphany. When the Faerie Godmother comes to you, be aware that this is a time when you will discover what has been long hidden to you. Your true self will be revealed in surprising ways every day, and sudden moments of heightened perception will make this time especially significant for you. People finally get found out, manipulators can be seen through, true costs of circumstances are revealed, and any lies about you will be seen. This can be hard, but it is truly a hardship that is born of protection. You are safer for knowing in whom you can trust in order to make the right choices for your soul. Throughout these revelations and insights will be a guiding hand, and this is the Fairy Godmother. She is showing you
what it is you need to know in order to create and foster a life that works for you. And she is a protective force too. So what you need will come to you now, sometimes in very strange ways. Be mindful of counting your blessings at this time, for this is the energy of your fairy godmother. And she can be drawn upon to keep transforming your life into one which is more abundant, magical, meaningful, and joyful. Note every moment of truth. They are all significant, and you are better for discovering what was once hidden from you. Artwork, Fairy Godmother. If you're still here, thanks for listening to this oracle reading. And please join us Wednesdays and Sunday nights live. If you would like some free cards pulled for you, I would love to pull them for you. Check the website out too. There are all kinds of perks for members over there. God bless, and talk to you again soon. Bye-bye for now.